December 28th, 9:51 a.m., District Court Defendant Lobby, Numero Dos. This is it. Judgment Day. Today, things are gonna get settled at last. A lot of things. Whoa! What's the big idea? Sorry, Nick, I only touched your shoulder. I guess the shock hasn't worn off from my run-in with the stun gun yet. It's not how stun guns work. Anyway, today's the last day of the trial. Good luck, Nick. Thanks, Maya. Edgeworth is looking glum as always. I gotta take a look at this new evidence real quick. Taken from Gregory Edgeworth's hearts, still bears clear ballistic markings. All I need to do is combine it with this gun or compare to this bullet. I hope Von Karma doesn't push him too hard. Whoa! What are you doing? Sorry, I'm sorry. I just thought I'd cheer you up with a pat on the back. Maya, maybe you should go outside and discharge. That's not the right word, Phoenix. Not the right word. Aw, oh, she's getting here, buddy. Yo, what's going on, Sam? Welcome, man. Oh, it's Mr. Gumshoe. What's gotten into that girl? Detective Gumshoe! Morning, Mr. Edgeworth! Good morning. How did it go, Detective? Have no fear, as promised, I've captured our runaway caretaker. I just brought him in. Took all night, pal. Thanks, Detective Gumshoe, you must be tired. Actually, after that shock I got on the way in, I feel pretty good. Yagi says he's forgotten his own name, but that has to be a lie. Why would he want revenge on Edgeworth if he couldn't remember his past? He does remember, and I'm gonna prove it. No, you're getting it wrong, Phoenix. Evidence, forgery, Manfred Von Karma. That's this whole thing, dude. Evidence. Forging so much evidence. Rabble, 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 rabble.
Court is now in session for the trial of Miles Edgeworth.
The defense is ready, Your Honor.
The prosecution is ready.
Right.
Very well. We have reached the final day of our proceedings in this trial. I ask that the prosecution submit decisive evidence.
Understood. Come on, don't be awed into silence by every little thing he says.
Very well, Mr. Von Karma. Your opening statement.
Right. Thanks to Detective Gumshoe's efforts, the boat's rental shop caretaker has been arrested. In yesterday's trial, the defense asserted that the caretaker was the murderer. However, the caretaker has yet to confirm this. I would like to ask the defense to cross-examine him as much as necessary.
Very well. Please bring the witness into the courtroom.
Ladies and gentlemen of the court, I believe you all remember our witness. He lives in the boat rental shop on the lake, from where he witnessed the incident. In addition, he has currently lost memory of his name and his identity.
Witness, why did you run away yesterday?
The witness was not running away, as he will now testify.
Ah, I see. Very well, please begin your testimony.
Pop. What's going on? All right. Why I left court.
I'm really sorry about just up and leaving yesterday like I did, but I wasn't running away or nothing. I went to buy some food for Polly, see? I figured I got nothing to do with this incident anyhow. I mean, one of those motive things, right? I don't got one. Though my testimony yesterday stands as is.
Very well. Let's begin the
cross-examination, shall we?
Has to know his name. Yanni Yogi. You're Yanni Yogi, and I'm gonna prove it. Why I left court. Alright, not here. I wanna press at Polly. Food?
Well, Paula's a bit of a gourmand, you see. She only eats these high-quality bird pellets from France. They only have them in the big pet shop downtown.
But you weren't arrested until this morning. Why didn't you go back to the caretaker's shack?
Well, I kinda got lost, you see.
The witness has trouble remembering things sometimes. When the police apprehended him, he was on his way back to the shack. Yeah, right. Nice try, Von Karma. No one's gonna believe that.
I see. So he was lost.
Please, Your Honor, come to your senses.
I figured I got nothing to do with this incident anyhow.
You've lost much of your memory, is that correct?
Yep, seems like it.
Then how could you know that you didn't have anything to do with this incident?
Or
maybe you're lying about not having your memory. You know exactly who you are.
The witness has testified quite clearly that he has no memory of who he is. If you claim he's lying, then show the court some proof.
How am I supposed to prove what's going on in that old codger's head? That's impossible. I'm glad you've come to your senses, Mr. Wright. What do I have as evidence? I got his parrot, Polly. I got the DL6 case file that also says that his old wife's name was Polly, which really helps. But I mean, naming a parrot Polly, that's totally reasonable. Photograph of the scene of the murder. Don't need to check it that right now, I think.
Very well, witness. Please continue.
I mean, I need one of those odor things, right? But I don't got one.
How can you say you have no motive? I say you do. You had a grudge against Edgeworth and the victim, Robert Hammond. That's why you took revenge on them, right?
Please don't make me repeat myself, Mr. Wright. The witness has no memory of anything beyond several years ago. He cannot hold a grudge. It is impossible.
I have to prove he's lying about his memory. Otherwise, it's going to be the same thing over and over until the trial ends.
Might I say something, Mr. Wright?
Yes, Your Honor.
You've been saying the same thing now, over and over. You've been calling the witness's memory of the past, or lack thereof, into question. But does this really have anything to do with the current case?
Of course, Your Honor. The witness has said he has nothing to do with this case, and no motive.
And both of these statements are lies!
Yeah.
Order! Order in my courtroom! Mr. Wright, this is a serious problem with your claim. Or, are you saying... are you saying you know who this witness is?
Of course, Your Honor!
Bah! Ugh! Now this is interesting. I would like to know myself, so... who is he?
He's baiting me out so hard. He's trying to bait me into this. I mean, I'm not gonna say the wrong ones.
His name is Yanni Yogi, a former court bailiff.
Yogi? That name seems familiar. Oh! Yanni Yogi, from the DL6 incident!
I thought the judge would never have heard of it. I thought the judge would have heard of it. It was such a famous case. But,
what does this mean?
Your Honor, if that man is Yogi, then he has a clear motive. Tisk, 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 Phoenix.
Oh, jumping to conclusions again, Mr. Wright. This man, this witness, this Yanni Yogi? Fascinating! However, how do you propose to prove this to the court? This is a court of law, as you may recall. You need proof. And allow me to once more repeat myself. The witness has lost his memory. This is it. I have to do this now. If I can't prove he's Yogi right here, right now, then I've got nowhere else to go.
Nick, how are you gonna prove it? How can you prove that he's Yanni Yogi?
Okay, it's actually quite simple. Your Honor, please take this man's fingerprints. Then, we'll compare them to the fingerprints on file for Yanni Yogi 15 years ago.
I see, that makes sense.
Tisk, 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 Nix.
Huh? I'm so very, very sorry, Mr. Wright.
Why?
The witness has no fingerprints.
What?
No fingerprints?
Well, you see, before I worked as a caretaker, I was at a chemical plant, and I burned my fingers working with the stuff. Yep.
What? Yogi, you sneak. You burned your fingerprints off to hide your past.
Well, if the witness has no fingerprints, I guess we will not be able to prove his identity.
No.
Well, what will you do, Mr. Wright?
It seems that the case has been decided, no? Not yet. Not yet, Von Karma. I know what happened. I know everything. I just can't prove it. But I can't let it end like this. I can't lose. There has to be another way. There's always another way. There is no one who can testify as to who this witness is. No one. Nick, what are we gonna do? I didn't even consider that he might have erased his fingerprints. What do I do?
Well, Mr. Wright, perhaps you'd like to cross-examine the parrot for a little comic relief,
Yeah, very funny. You're a sore winner, Von Karma. No, dude, legit. I knew it. I knew the parrot was gonna come in! What is it, Nick? No. You're not gonna... Your Honor! I'd like to cross-examine that fucking parrot! Oh my god! I would like to cross-examine the witness's parrot! Right now! Right here! It's Kangaroo Court! It's Kangaroo Court, man!
Order! Order! There'll be no birds in my court of law!
The literal definition of bird law. Oh man, I gotta title this final chapter Bird Law when I put it on YouTube, man.
Well, what do you think of this, Mr. Von Karma?
Need you even ask? This is a farce and I object! Wait a second! You were the one who suggested I cross-examine the parrot, Von Karma! I have a right to do as you suggested. Well, if you're so desperate, then please, be my guest. Of course, should you go through with this, and nothing comes of it, then I hope you're ready for the consequences. Nick, this is crazy. Well, still want to go through with your little game? Hell yeah, dude! Hell yeah! This is the most ridiculous thing I have ever heard. Von Karma's rigged every person's testimony, every piece of evidence, except for the parrot. The one thing he couldn't screw with ahead of time.
Bailiff, bring in that parrot.
As if it was like ready to be oh my fucking god. This is so funny.
That's quite a bird. Please tell us your name. Name! The witness is ignoring me.
It must hurt. Be ignored by a bird.
Ahem. Very well, witness. Who is your owner? Please testify for us, I guess?
Hello! Hello! Squawk!
Certainly the most concise testimony we've had so far. Very well, begin your cross-examination.
Right. What are you gonna do, Nick?
I don't know.
Hold on right there! Witness, you can't just say hello and expect us to get anywhere. I want you to testify. Maya, you talk to her. Right, what do I say? Have we forgotten something? Polly, have we forgotten something?
Squawk! Don't forget DL6! Squawk!
That's right. Yeah, dude. Polly, have we forgotten something?
Hello! Squawk!
Didn't do it! Not what you're supposed to say.
forgot something we forgot. Oh no, dude. Not working, she won't say it. Tisk tisk. Something the matter, Mr. Wright. Wait a second. Don't tell me Von Karma expected this. Couldn't have retrained the parrot, could he? Did he train her to not respond when asked if we'd forgotten anything? Yo, this is a fake parrot, I'm betting. Witness, you're here to speak. You must speak to me. Frankly, I can't believe that you're speaking to the parrot. Well, I guess we should try to get some information out of her. We need to show the judge that her owner is Mr. Yagi. All right, let's try presenting the DL6 case file. Your Honor, that state... God... I just want to bring up the fact that his dead wife's name is Polly. Let's try just pressing and asking a different question. What's your name? Let's go with what's your name. Maybe I should get her to say your name. Polly, what's your name?
Polly, squawk!
Mr. Wright, I think we've established that this parrot is named Polly. Does this have anything to do with her owner's identity? Of course. Yes, it does. Huh, fascinating. You claim that the parrot's name will prove her owner's identity? Then show us this proof. Don't you think we're bluffing a little too far? Listen, Maya, we're not here to answer the question of who is the caretaker. We're here to prove that he is Yanni Yogi. All we have to do is tie the name Polly to Yogi. Your Honor, the proof that the parrot's name reveals the caretaker's identity is right here in the case file of the DL6 incident on the final page. Polly Jenkins, Yanni Yogi's fiance, committed suicide after his arrest. Thus, his motive is now clear. The DL6 case file? That's quite a large file you have there. Which page is proof on it then? Show us or stop wasting our time.
Very well, Mr. Wright. Please show us the page. Where in this file is the information connected to the parrot's... to the parrot's name?
The suspect data. It is on the suspect data page, Your Honor. This page has all the information about Yanni Yogi. Right after he was arrested, his fiancée committed suicide, see?
Indeed, it does say that, yes.
And what was his fiancée's name, Your Honor?
Polly Jenkins. Polly!
Exactly, Your Honor. He remembered the name of his fiancée who committed suicide. That's why he named his parrot after her. I see. I guess that is possible. Bah, a mere coincidence, that's all. My granddaughter has a dog she calls Phoenix. Well, Mr. Phoenix Wright, does this make you my granddaughter's fiancé? She's only 7 years old.
Indeed. Alone, it is a little weak for evidence in a murder trial. We would need something other to corroborate evidence.
Where am I gonna find that? Nick, we're getting closer, Nick. One more, if we can just get one more piece of evidence. Very well, witness, you may continue. Let's try the last question. Maybe I'll get her to say the number of that safe. Huh? The safe? Why? Let's just see if we can get her to say anything, okay? Polly, what's the number of the safe in the shack?
1228! 1228!
My, what a reckless parrot! Well, Mr. Wright, you aren't claiming that this number has something to do with the caretaker.
Does this show up anywhere else? 1228! 1228! 1228, 1228! This the day of the DL6 incident! Actually, Your Honor, it does, and that's why your boy had her say it. Ha! Ridiculous! How can the number to a safe tell us who the caretaker is? Show us your proof, Phoenix! What could it possibly link this number to the caretaker's true identity?
Oh.
Keep The DL6 case file? What is this obsession you have with that case?
Mr. Wright, where in this file is something relating to that safe number?
Why, right in the case summary, Your Honor.
The case summary?
Specifically, the date on which the DL6 incident occurred. The date of the incident, December 28th. Why, that's today's date, 15 years ago. And the number on that safe is 1228. Oh! He used the date of the DL6 incident as number for his safe, Your Honor. And that's how important that date was to him.
I see. It certainly is an interesting coincidence. People often do set their secret numbers to dates.
Bah, this is not tangible proof. I set my ATM card's number to 10001 because I'm number one. This has nothing to do with a date. Nothing.
Now that is enough. I think we've reached a conclusion here.
This is a mere coincidence, that's all.
True, that is a possibility, but however, two coincidences at the same time seems more like a pattern to me.
What are you saying?
Summon the caretaker of the boat shop immediately. Witness, tell us your name.
Wait, this witness, he doesn't remember.
No, it's okay.
I've accomplished what I've wanted to do. I'm done. Nick, he looks totally different. This is the real Yagi, I think. He's been acting feeble to hide his true identity. Acting. For 15 years.
Well, let me ask you again. Please state your name for the court.
My name is Yanni Yagi. 15 years ago, I served as a bailiff in this very court.
Order! Order! Yanni Yagi, so was it you who killed Robert Hammond and tried to frame Miles as Edgeworth for his death?
Yes. It was me. I did it. They put me on that witness stand 15 years ago. Robert Hammond, he said I was mentally unsound. He told me it would make me innocent, get me off the hook. So, I pretended to have brain damage. I was innocent, really! But he didn't believe me. We won the trial, but I lost everything. I lost my job, my fiance, my social standing. Then this year, 15 years later, a package arrived. It was a letter and a pistol. The plan was written out in careful detail. It was a plan for me to take my revenge on the people who ruined my life. I didn't care who had sent it. I thought this was my chance after 15 years. This was it. Finally, a chance to have my revenge on Robert Hammond and on Miles Edgeworth. I have no regrets.
Wait a moment. Revenge? Against Miles Edgeworth? What do you mean?
I'm not at liberty to speak on that matter. Why don't you ask Mr. Edgeworth yourself? Anyway, I admit it. I was the one who killed Robert Hammond.
Von Karma. Where is Mr. Yagi?
Under arrest, Your Honor. I saw no room for error in his confession.
Then the defendant, Miles Edgeworth, is...
innocent. In this case, at least.
Very well. Will the defendant please take the stand? There are a few mysteries left unsolved. Still, you are cleared of suspicion for this particular case. So I would like to pass judgment on the murder of Mr. Robert Hammond. Any objections?
I don't believe it. Why isn't Von Karma saying anything?
Very well. The court finds the defendant, Mr. Miles Edgeworth, not guilty.
No!
That is all. The court is adjourned.
Objection!
Did somebody just say objection?
Wasn't Von Karma. Wait. But that means... no. Edgeworth? Ahem! Ahem, ahem!
Your Honor, I object to your judgment.
What do you mean?
I'm not innocent at all. As we have heard, Yanni Yagi killed Robert Hammond in revenge. But revenge for what?
Nick! Edgeworth is trying to confess. He's gonna say he's guilty. He's gonna tell them he was the murderer in the DL6 incident. And he's gonna tell them that he killed his own dad. Oh, what do I do? Leave it to Edgeworth. No, I trust him. He's buying us time right now. Nick, are you sure? There's nothing we can do about it. This is his problem now.
Years. I've had a recurring dream. A nightmare. And it's only a nightmare. That's what I told myself. But now I know it wasn't a dream. Yanni Yogi wasn't the killer.
You mean, in the incident where your father won?
From the distance of the shot, it wasn't suicide either. Everything was as clear as day. The murderer. The criminal in the DL6 incident. It was me. Your Honor, I confess my guilt. I am guilty for DL6, the statute of limitations, which ends today. The culprit is me.
Order! Order! This is certainly unexpected. The defendant declared innocent is confessing to a different crime. A crime for which the statute of limitations runs out today. I'm not really sure how I should deal with this one.
Blah! It's obvious we hold a trial right here, right now. We try this man for his crime of 15 years ago. That's right, we're baiting in Von Karma right now.
I think I would like to take a 5-minute recess to process everything. During this time, I will consider the appropriate course of action to take. Court is adjourned!
Holy shit, dude. There's some natty stuff we're going on right now.
I'm sorry, Wright. I've just wasted all of your effort.
Mr. Edgeworth, I just don't believe it, pal. I mean, you killed your dad?
I didn't want to believe it myself, Detective.
But it's the truth,
and I deserve to be punished. Murder is murder no matter what the circumstances.
This is crazy, just crazy! Nick, what are you doing?
Huh? Oh, I was just reading through the court record once more. I'm getting my case ready.
Case? For what?
What? Isn't it obvious? I'm gonna prove that Miles Edgeworth is innocent.
What are you talking about, pal? He just admitted it.
The hardest case yet.
He confessed that he did it in court.
I'm sorry, Edgeworth, but I don't believe your nightmare.
What?
It's just a dream. It's not real.
The truth is right here in this court record.
In any case, tighten your belts, because the real fight, well, it's just beginning. I'm gonna prove you're innocent. Trust me.
Right.
All right then, I would like to resume our trial.
Judge! Miles Edgeworth has admitted his own guilt. He has confessed his crime. Let us begin by hearing his testimony. Then, though pointless, let the defense do their cross-examination. The statute of limitations on the DL6 incident runs out today. Though it is unconventional for me, I'd like to run this one by the book.
I see. Does the defense have any objections?
No, Your Honor.
Von Karma.
You knew this was gonna happen from the very beginning, didn't you?
Very well. Will Miles Edgeworth please take the stand?
Will the witness state his name and profession?
Miles Edgeworth. I am a prosecuting attorney.
Mr. Edgeworth, 15 years ago, you mistakenly killed your father, Gregory Edgeworth. Is this correct?
It is correct.
Then testify about this matter to the court.
Edgeworth was telling me about his dream yesterday. I noticed something. One detail didn't quite fit.
That'll be the key, but only if I can get it to work.
Please. Please. Yell sixes.
That day, I had gone to the courtroom to observe one of my father's trials. As we went to leave, an earthquake struck, trapping us in an elevator. My father and Mr. Yagi lost their composure and began to argue. Just then, something heavy fell at my feet. I picked it up and threw it at Mr. Yagi. I wanted them to stop fighting. A moment later, there was a single gunshot and then a scream. It was a terrible scream, and I remember it to this day. That's all.
And until now, you thought this memory was a dream?
We were stuck in that elevator for 5 hours. The oxygen in the elevator ran out, and I lost my memory of events. Blah! The same claim Mr. Yogi has made.
Very well. Mr. Wright, your cross-examination, please.
Yes, Your Honor. I gotta look over my evidence, man. How am I gonna present this one? What do I have? I have this spare bullet. I have this DL6 incident photo. Yo, right here! Yeah, look! The glass is damaged. The glass has a bullet hole. It can't have come from inside. That's my evidence, I think. I think I have something here. I picked up and threw it. Okay, so let's press here. Now, what was it that fell to your feet?
A pistol. I assume it was the bailiff, Yanni Yagi's.
The safety must have come off when it fell from his holster.
And you picked it up. What happened next?
I picked it up and threw it. I wanted them to stop fighting.
Did you know it was a pistol when you threw it?
I think I knew.
I knew it was dangerous, but the air was getting so thick, I panicked.
So, you're saying that you threw this pistol at Mr. Yagi?
I was in a daze. A moment later, there was a single gunshot, and then a scream. The gun fired once? Two gunshots, though, right? The murder weapon was fired twice. That's right. Just like this case. The scream. Okay, let's go back. A single gunshot.
Objection!
Hold on there, Miles. Are you sure you only heard one gunshot?
Yes, that I am sure of.
I heard the shot and the scream. Then everything faded. I was unconscious until the rescuers came.
I see.
But that doesn't make sense, Your Honor. Look at this file one more time. This plainly contradicts the witness's testimony day and night.
You do enjoy dragging out that file, don't you, boy? I don't accept this evidence unless you can tell us what page it's on.
It's on page 2, I believe. 2, yeah. Victim data. Look at this victim data in the file. It says quite plainly the murder weapon was fired twice.
There you go, Your Honor.
Miles Edgeworth only heard one gunshot, yet the murder weapon was fired twice. The first shot was the accidental firing when the pistol was thrown.
So who fired the remaining shot?
Yeah.
Was there perhaps another shooter who fired that second shot?
Your Honor, as I'm sure you're aware, the incident occurred 15 years ago. The evidence is dated. The pistol did fire twice. However, we do not know when that second shot was fired. It might have been fired the day before the incident. There is no proof that the second shot had anything to do with this incident. What? I see. You do have a point, Mr. Wright.
The murder weapon was fired twice, as we have heard. One of those shots was fired by the defendant, a boy at the time. Do you have any proof that the other shot fired had something to do with this case?
Why, yes I do, Your Honor. I think I'll be able to show you right now.
Nande?
Now, Von Karma,
save your surprise for after you've seen the evidence.
Very well, Mr. Wright.
Show us your proof. Do you have evidence that the second firing of the pistol is related to this incident?
Bullet wound, crack in the window, there was an earthquake, they couldn't escape, no one could have shot from outside.
Take
that! Now take a look at this photo.
Look at this photograph!
This is a photograph of the scene of the crime 15 years ago. I can see that the victim lying there is Gregory Edgeworth.
This proves the murder weapon was fired twice at the time of the incident. The photo proves it.
Well, let me get this straight. The photo proves that two shots were fired where?
Your Honor, please get a clue.
Show the judge the contradiction in the photo.
As should be obvious, the contradiction is here.
I see a bullet hole in the door.
Your Honor, Gregory Edgeworth was killed by a shot from the pistol, yes. But there is also a bullet hole in the elevator door. We know that the murder weapon was fired twice. Thus, someone other than Edgeworth fired that second shot.
Order! Order, I say! Mr. Wright, what are you driving at?
Well, it's simple, Your Honor. At the time of the incident, two shots were fired. One went into Gregory Edgeworth's heart. The other hit the elevator door. Remember that the defendant lost consciousness after the shot he fired rang out. In conclusion, we must agree that the second shot was fired by someone else.
Mr. Wright, but who could that someone else be?
The murderer, of course.
I knew I should have stepped in before your wild fantasies got out of hand. Mr. Wright,
look once more at the DL6 incident case file, and look closely. Try the case summary page. What? Okay, so the case summaries page. Elevator, district court, air in elevator was oxygen depleted at the time of incident, no clues found on the... How does that change anything? Wait, no clues found on the scene? Did it say that? That's gotta be it. No clues found on the scene, except for... bullet. Taken from Gregory Edgeworth's heart. The case summary, that's on page one. Look what's written there. Not a single clue was found on the scene. Huh? If the pistol had indeed been fired two times, then the other bullet would have been discovered on the scene.
He does have a point.
That second bullet has never been found. Why? Because the second bullet does not exist! The bullet that claimed Gregory Edgeworth's life was the one fired by his own son. That is the truth of this matter. The whole truth. It was undoubtedly something else that made the bullet hole in the door. What do you mean, something else?
Order, I will have order. Mr. Wright has proven one thing to us quite clearly, that the murder weapon was fired twice at the incident of the crime. However, as Mr. Von Karma says, the second bullet fired was not found. It is highly unlikely that the police merely overlooked this second bullet. So all we have is the single bullet fired, and I'm afraid I have to discount the defense's claim.
Disc. I praise the judge for his wisdom in the matter. How did this happen? I don't believe this second bullet doesn't exist. Was I wrong? Have I been wrong about the whole incident? What are you doing, Nick? Why aren't you raising an objection? I'm sorry, Maya. No, don't give up on yourself, Phoenix. It looks like I was wrong. Nick? If the second bullet wasn't there, then all my conjectures are for nothing. No. But you said you'd do it, Nick. You said you'd get Edgeworth declared innocent. I'm sorry. It's just...
Photograph.
I thought there had been two shots fired. I was so certain of it. I thought I'd won. I thought there was another person, someone else who fired the killing shot. But now... I was wrong to think it could be that simple. This case has stood unsolved for 15 years. Nick.
Well, it seems that we've finally cleared up this incident. Only one bullet was found at the scene of the crime. That shot was fired by Miles Edgeworth.
Precisely.
I would like to ask one thing of Miles Edgeworth before passing my verdict. Have you been paying attention to the trial so far?
Yes, Your Honor.
Do you have any objections?
No. No, I do not.
So you killed your father, though that was not your intention?
Yes, I did. Oh no, he's confessing.
Very well. The statute of limitations on the murder of Gregory Edgeworth runs out today. And therefore, I must pronounce a verdict on the defendant today, right here, right now.
Right now.
Indeed. Does anyone have any objections?
I've been here before. It's just like my first day in court. There's so many things I know I should be saying, but my mind's gone blank and I can't find the words. I haven't used this yet. I don't have the gun as evidence anymore. Oh, I do. It's right here. I have an objection, Your Honor. Your Honor, I object. Mr. Wright, on what grounds do you object? Nick? I don't know. His case is perfect. Oh, no. It must exist. The second bullet. What? What did you just say? Nothing. The second bullet must exist, but where? Someone took it.
It seems waiting is not going to produce an answer for Mr. Wright.
Wait, Your Honor. The second bullet, it does exist.
What? But we've just heard proof that it did not exist.
I realize that, Your Honor.
I'm really
grasping here, but... It's just... Someone took it from the scene of the crime, and that's what happened.
Really? But who?
The murderer! The murderer? Then tell us, just who is this murderer? I'm still thinking about that one.
So the criminal took the second bullet. Why would he?
Huh?
First of all, how would he have found it? It's not easy to find a stray bullet, Mr. Wright. Was there some pressing need for the murderer to search for that bullet?
Oh, of course there was a need. That's why they found it. But what possible reason could he have had? Well, the reason the murderer took the bullet away from the scene with him is... I don't know. I'm grasping here.
I'm trying to think. The bullet would be proof. Yeah, I guess so, yeah. That just makes sense. Maybe he thought the bullet would be used as proof.
Proof?
It was a special bullet, so he took it with him.
If that's the case, then he would have taken the bullet from inside Gregory as well.
Why would he only take one of the two shots fired?
Oh, right.
Mr. Wright, have you really thought this through?
I'm going to penalize you.
Why would the murderer have spent time looking for the stray bullet? I haven't got a clue.
What's wrong, Mr. Wright?
Bah! The murderer had no reason to take that bullet! You don't want to admit it, but it's true.
Had to take it. I just said that. The murderer? What does that mean? You're thinking too normal. Think crazy. Don't think why the bullet was taken. Think why the bullet had to be taken.
Mr. Wright?
Yes, Your Honor. Well, the murderer had no intention of taking the bullet from the scene, but the murderer had to take the bullet from the scene.
Had to, Mr. Wright? What do you mean?
Well, for instance...
For instance what?
Maybe the bullet, hit the murderer.
Hit the murderer!
The bullet? Hit the murderer?
Just saying, for instance, I mean, if it hit you, you would have to take it with you, wouldn't you? It's not like you could perform surgery right there. You know? It actually makes so much sense!
Let me get this straight. At the time of the murderer himself was shot and left with a second bullet still inside, thus leaving only one bullet at the scene of the crime.
Yeah. I guess that's how it works.
But there's a problem with that. The other two people rescued from the elevator, Miles Edgeworth and Yanni Yogi, were both unharmed. So that would mean...
The murderer came from outside. Yes. The two men fight inside the elevator. Trying to stop them, the boy picks up the pistol at his feet, and he throws it. The pistol discharges in the bullet. The bullet goes through the elevator door and hits the murderer outside. The boy loses consciousness. Then, the murderer opens the elevator door and sees men inside.
Mr. Wright. You are truly the most unpredictable defense attorney I've ever known. I can tell you're grasping, yet I cannot deny the possibility of what you're saying.
Blah! What are you saying? Deny it! Deny it! No one involved with the incident was wounded. There was no murderer!
No one was wounded at the time of the incident. That's right, I can't think of anyone. Hey, Nick. Huh. I just thought of something really crazy. Crazy? Remember what Mr. Grossberg said yesterday?
Gregory Edgeworth dealt a blow to his perfect trial record.
Wow.
It must have been quite the shock for Von Karma. He took a vacation for several months after that, you see. Yes, an unusual event for the man. That was the first and the last vacation he's ever taken in the many years of his prosecution.
See, I told you he was the murderer. What if Von Karma didn't take that vacation because of shock? But took it because he was injured? Which would mean... It could only mean one thing. He was the murderer in the DL6 incident! He was the man who shot Gregory Edgeworth. It was Von Karma!
Oh man, something wrong, Mr. Wright? You seem... dazed.
No, Your Honor, no.
Well, you have indicated the possibility that the murderer came from outside. Can you give us the name of your suspect?
Uh-oh. Should I come out with it and say it now? I'm saving it. I don't have enough proof yet. This is my trump card. I'd better save it for the right time.
Mr. Wright, something the matter?
I'm fine, Your Honor. Tsk, tsk, tsk. Shall we carry on with the trial, then? That said, we have no farther to go. All that is left is
the finish. In other words, the verdict. What? Not yet. Think, Mr. Wright. You have said that someone from the outside was the murderer, yet you cannot suggest anybody as a possible suspect, which means your conjecture is worthless and will be rejected, of course. Nick, now's no time to be holding onto that trump card. The trial's almost over. All right, I guess I gotta jump in and do it. Your Honor, there is a suspect. There is one lone suspect.
Well, this is certainly interesting news. Very well, Mr. Wright. Who is your suspect?
My hands are shaking.
What?
Von Karma himself. Von Karma? My God.
You mean the Von Karma? Prosecutor sitting right here?
Bah.
You don't object?
I see no need. Why honor this ridiculous outburst with my objection? Because you took a vacation for several months starting the day after the incident. Yet you pride yourself on a perfect record. Why would you take such a long vacation without reason? So you're claiming that I took a vacation to heal my injury from the incident? Fascinating. Prove it. I would have needed surgery, no? Where would I go under the knife, Mr. Wright? Bring the doctor that operated me. Have him testify. Nick, let's find out who his doctor is. It's no use. Edgeworth? I know Von Karma too well. He's perfect. He wouldn't leave clues. He probably didn't undergo surgery. That would leave a doctor as a witness. Nobody's that perfect. So what, Nick? Did Von Karma pull the bullet out by himself? That's insane. No, he couldn't have. You can't just pull bullets out of yourself. Wait a minute. What does that mean? The bullet has to be somewhere. But where? Tisk, tisk, tisk. Tisk yourself, Karma. Can you produce evidence that I was shot? All right, Von Karma, I'll prove it, and I'll even use evidence. I know how you like it so much. What? The evidence proves right here that you were shot. The only reason we're still holding on to this piece of shit metal detector. Von Karma is perfect, Your Honor. He wouldn't risk surgery after leaving an evidence trail. So then I ask, where is that bullet right now? I think it unlikely that Von Karma performed surgery on himself.
You don't mean.
I do. There is the possibility that the bullet is still inside Von Karma to this day. That's right.
Is that even possible? For all these years?
Well, there is one way to find out. We could use this metal detector. Well, Von Karma, I'm gonna run over you and see what we find. He's sweating! I refuse!
You refuse? But refusing this means... You acknowledge that the bullet is still inside you?
Nani? Order! 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 Your Honor, the defense requests that we be allowed to use the metal detector. Judge, I call for a suspension of this trial. This is an invasion of privacy. The statute of limitations runs out on this case today, Your Honor. We can't afford to waste the time. It was you who said we had to end this right here, right now.
Enough. I permit the use of the metal detector. Mr. Von Karma, you will submit yourself to testing.
Nick, what does this mean? I don't know, but... we have to give it a shot. Yes! Mr. Von Karma. You. It was you! I was afraid this would happen. And so I remained silent. Indeed, there is a bullet in my shoulder.
However, it has nothing to do with this incident.
What? I was shot in the shoulder long before the DL6 incident. I claim that the bullet in my shoulder has no relation to DL6.
What?
But Mr. Von Karma, can you prove that?
Prove? I have no obligation to prove anything, Your Honor. It is you who must prove something here, Mr. Wright, not I.
Mr. Wright? Well, can you prove it? Can you prove the bullet in Von Karma's shoulder was from DL6?
Of course he can't! You don't have any of the DL6 evidence! That's because you took it out of the records room yesterday! With no proof, you cannot convict me of any crime. So sorry, Mr. Wright. Nope! I'm the one who's sorry, Mr. Von Karma.
What?
You were close. One day away from freedom. You see, Von Karma, I have proof. That's right. Who would have thought that you would have dug your own grave trying to convict Edgeworth? I can link that bullet in your shoulder to the DL6 incident. And here is my final proof. It's gotta be this bullet.
That's... a bullet?
Where did you get that? This is the bullet used in the DL6 incident. This was taken from the heart of the victim, Mr. Gregory Edgeworth. The bullet is preserved quite nicely with all the ballistic markings.
Ballistic?
Ballistic markings?
Oh shit, Edgeworth doesn't have that voice. You may recall the term. It came up in the first trial 2 days ago.
Ballistic markings are the fingerprints of a weapon. All bullets fired from a gun are marked with that weapon's unique pattern. By examining the markings, you can tell which weapon fired the bullet. It is quite accurate.
We have two bullets in our possession, Your Honor. One, the bullet removed from Gregory Edgeworth's heart. And the other, Mr. Von Karma, the bullet buried in your shoulder. We can analyze both bullets. Then, if the markings matched, we would know that both bullets had been fired from the same gun, the very same pistol, and in other words, the murder weapon that killed Gregory Edgeworth. Mr. Von Karma, you will let us remove the bullet from your shoulder. Then we'll compare the ballistic markings to those on this bullet and solve this case once and for all.
Well, Mr. Von Karma!
That scream. I've heard that scream before.
Wait, I know!
Help! I can't breathe!
Quiet! I said quiet! You're not making this any easier! Stop breathing my air! I'll stop you! Stop breathing my air!
Get away!
Get away from my father!
Bang. It's that scream I heard in the elevator. 15 years ago.
Von Karma, it was you who screamed!
Mr. Von Karma.
Edgeworth! Only you would defy me!
So it was you.
You and your father are my curse! Your father shamed me with a penalty on my record, and you left a scar on my shoulder that would never fade. I'll bury you! I'll bury you with my bare hands! Death! Death!
15 years earlier. Mr. Chief Prosecutor, I'm so sorry. Von Karma, it's not like you to make this kind of error. I never would have thought that Edgeworth would be one to catch you. I was careless. I'm sorry, but you will have to be penalized. I've covered for you in the past, but not this time.
Edgeworth.
It was a shock like none I had ever known.
Me? Penalized?
It took hours for me to regain my composure. Suddenly, I found myself in the darkness. I was in the court records room. I must have wandered in there without thinking where I was going. The room was pitch black. The lights, they must have gone out. I went into the hall and felt my way to the escalator. I pressed the button, but nothing happened. Then, there was a noise. I was in pain! Horrible burning pain in my shoulder. And just then, the lights came back on. The elevator opened before my eyes. I saw three people inside, all lying unconscious from oxygen deprivation. Much to my surprise, a pistol lay at my feet. I knew then why it was destiny. Merry Christmas. In his last moments, Gregory Edgeworth was still unconscious. He died never knowing who shot him. Later, he spoke through a medium, blaming Mr. Yagi. He was fooled. It was a perfect crime. Tisk, tisk. Who would have thought that another man would have come to open that elevator door? Judge!
What?
What are you doing? Do your job. Bring an end to this miserable charade. Now, end it!
Very well. It appears that we have come a very long way to the end of this maze. 15 years later, Mr. Miles Edgeworth?
Yes, Your Honor.
You were innocent. You are innocent. As you said, it was all a nightmare.
Yes, Your Honor.
This judge finds the defendant, Mr. Miles Edgeworth, not guilty.
Meanwhile...
That is all. The court is adjourned.
Whoa. Put Von Karma away, though. Send him to jail. Did it, guys. Nick, we did it! Did you see his face? Von Karma looked even paler than usual. Aw, he's pretending to be cool, but you crushed him, Nick. I gotta say, I'm impressed. It was a pretty close one, though. I was sure we'd had it. I know, I was on the verge of tears the whole time myself. But now it's all just a good memory. So it's finally over, Edgeworth. Right? Yeah? I'm not sure how to say this. I know. Try thank you. I see. Thank you, right? You're welcome, Miles. I think you could have done better than that. Oh, sorry, I'm not good at this sort of thing. You got a lot to learn, Edgeworth. Woo! Amazing, pal. You pulled through just like I thought you would. I'll never forget this. I owe you one, pal. And tonight, let's party. Dinner's on me. Yeah, my salary went down a bit this month, but who cares? See, Mr. Edgeworth, you should take a lesson from Detective Gunshoe. That's how you say thank you. I see. Ahem. Whoop! I feel foolish. Don't worry. Take it a little at a time. You'll get used to it. It's been 15 years since I've seen Edgeworth this unguarded. Hey, y'all! Lotta! Y'all were great in there! Thanks, Lotta! Yo, Edgeworth, congrats! Thank you very much. I knew y'all were innocent from the start, of course. Just look at you, you wouldn't stick your hand in a cookie jar even if Nan was there! You were the witness on the first day of the trial, weren't you? Yeah, well, let bygones be bygones! Speaking of which, what are you doing now, Lotta?
Who, me? I went back to college. I gave up trying to be an investigative photographer pretty quick. Really? That's too bad. Huh? Isn't that the hot dog guy from the park?
It's over, Nick.
My life's over.
Why with the sad face, Larry? What happened now?
Oh, Nick. I'm not long for this world.
You don't look sick.
It's Keontae. She's going to live in Paris. Paris, Nick. She's leaving me behind.
Oh, but yo, Edgy, there you are.
Yes, here I am.
Congrats, Edgy. Here, a little gift for me in celebration.
Celebration? That's unusual for ya.
Harry Butts, you come along tonight too. My treat, pal.
Huh? Oh, thanks. Looking forward to it.
Yo, Nick. That's the suit that questioned me. When he says treat, it's not police talk for prison food, right?
I think you'll be fine, Larry.
Right.
Yeah? What's up?
$36 in it, or $38. Yeah, called it. Larry stole the money way back when.
That envelope that Larry gave me, it's got money in it.
Well, yeah, that's not that strange. People give money away to celebrate sometimes.
It's $38, right?
Huh? What a weird amount. I mean, it's not a little, but it's not a lot either.
Wait, 38 exactly?
Nick!
Wasn't that exactly the amount of lunch money that was stolen from Mr. Edgeworth in school?
38.
No! No! Larry, it was you?
What are you so surprised about, right?
Larry was absent that day from school, right? But that doesn't automatically rule him out as a suspect.
What?
Think back to that day, 15 years ago. Larry took the day off, but he was bored, so he came into school anyway. Then, he saw the money lying there. And the rest is history.
Aw, I never was good at history.
Edgeworth, you didn't know, did you?
I suspected. I just couldn't picture Larry protecting you like he did that day. Everyone else was saying you did it. The whole case was against you, remember?
Yeah, too well.
Right, you may not know this, but we used to have a saying back in school. When something smells, it's usually the butts.
I know.
Really, right, I'm surprised you didn't figure it out.
Well, this sure is an unexpected turn of events, huh?
Edgeworth.
You should have told me.
Now, Nick, it was 15 years ago. Don't you think the statute of limitations has run out?
Where does that leave me? I became a defense attorney because of that.
Well, I'd call you a goody two-shoes to the extreme then.
Yeah, and you get worked up too easily too.
The death sentence for both of you.
If only the other way around. For the longest time, I thought that I might have killed my own father. I thought I might be a criminal. I became a prosecutor in part to punish myself. If I had known the truth, I might have become a defense attorney after all.
Edgeworth.
Want to switch, right?
Hey, y'all. Line up. I'll take a photo.
Ooh, photo time. Let's go. And after that, dinner on me.
Detective Gumshoe took us out on the town that night. We celebrated Edgeworth's newfound freedom, although Edgeworth was still in detention.
May 9th, 5:02 a.m. The following day, real early. What's going on?
Whoa. I went a little overboard yesterday. My head hurts.
Huh? Still only 5? Maybe I should go back to sleep.
Huh?
What's this? A letter?
Good morning, Nick. You were really impressive yesterday. Seeing you, well, it made me think about what I'm doing here. I'm a spirit medium, in training, of course. And I want to help Mr. Edgeworth, too. I want to help you, but I just couldn't. I was useless. So I've decided to go back to my training. I'm going to become a full-fledged spirit medium, for starters. I couldn't say it to your face, so I left this letter. Goodbye, Nick.
Farewell, my dear companion.
What time is it?
Ugh! The first trains for the mountains have already left! To the station!
You gonna find her?
I guess I'm too late.
Hey! Nick! Maya!
Man, oh, you're leaving?
Yeah, it's hard being a spirit medium who can't talk to spirits. And, well, I think you'd do fine without me, Nick. Be good, okay?
Hold it!
Hold it! Aw, I love that.
What?
I never could have saved Edgeworth without your help.
Huh?
On the last day of the trial, I heard her. I heard Mia's voice.
You heard my sister?
Yes, only her voice, but still. It was at the very end when I thought we'd lost everything.
Well, that's my sister for you.
Detective Gumshoe helped, and Mr. Grossberg, and even Larry. I'm the only one who couldn't help. I was useless, Nick. But you were the one who stopped Von Karma, Maya.
Huh?
I didn't do anything. All I did was wander around in a daze. Sorry, but I have evidence that you helped.
Evidence?
Yeah, dude, you got this bullet. You found this.
A bullet?
Von Karma was convinced he had taken all of the evidence pertaining to the DL6, but you were the one who rescued the last piece that we needed. This was the bullet that put an end to Von Karma, and you were the one who gave it to me.
Nick.
Thanks, Maya. I really couldn't have done it without you.
I'll be back soon.
Huh? I'm gonna complete my training and come back.
Alright. I'll be waiting.
Of course you will. You can't run that office by yourself. You're hopeless.
I don't know about that.
Choo choo! So, bye.
Bye.
Aw, look at that. Tears falling out of her eyes as she walks away.
Arigato, Nick.
And so my story ends. It's time to turn a new page. Say goodbye to the novice defense attorney that I once was. Now, a new story begins. With the same old crazy cast of characters.
Ha! Don't think you've graduated yet, amateur!
Mr. Wright, perhaps you'd like to rethink that claim?
Yes, Your Honor. Uh-oh. I got a bad feeling about this! Hey, pal. Mr. Edgeworth came down to the precinct to wish me a Happy New Year. Talk about a pleasant surprise.
Whoop!
Aw, that's great. He hung his head low and went right back outside. Kinda like he was embarrassed or something. Strange, huh? This is fantastic. This is fantastic. This has been really fun. We don't have time to do bonus chapter today, guys. Plus, doing more than one case a day kind of, like, hurts my voice. But I can hang around for a little while longer. That Missy's a nice late. Oh, shit. I guess so. She's in Hawaii right now. Yeah. Yeah.
Who? Right? Yes, I remember him. I hear he's been busy lately. You know, not to ring my own bell, but I sort of taught him everything he knows. I'm sure he's grateful.
The bellboy. Ah, Phoenix Wright. Ah, yes, the defense attorney for whom I wrote that affidavit. Oh, you should know I've taken over management of the Gatewater Hotel recently. Should you be in the area, please stop by.
Oh, it's you? Oh, Phoenix Wright. Oh, yeah, Mia's understudy, was he not?
I wonder how he's doing. I haven't seen him as of late. The days of my youth, like the scent of fresh lemon, you see.
Oh, Phoenix Wright? He's an actor. Well, I'm not buying it. Can't be a star with a name like Phoenix. Do you know they're finally putting Hammer back in the DVD shelves? That too? And not even in any of those naughty films. He's got a real role.
I'm pleased to announce The Pink Princess is a hit. I sure owe that Mr. Wright a great deal. Oh, and I'm keeping my face out of public eye until the show's over. I wouldn't want to ruin any kid's dreams, you know?
Oh, I got a letter from Maya the other day. It sounded like she caught a cold standing under a waterfall. I wanted to visit, but I didn't have time. So I sent her some Pink Princess trading cards. She says she can't buy them where she is. What kind of a place is she living anyway?
Right? Who dat? You wanna talk? Let's talk Pink Princess, alright? But, you know, I snuck into the studio the other day, and I saw her. The one inside the Pink Princess suit. Oh, what a dog! It's kind of a shock for a boy of my tender age.
Yeah, I remember right. That lawyer guy. Huh, me? Well, I'm in training to become a paranormal photographer. You know that picture I took of everyone? Well, just behind him there's this ghost. For real! Now that's talent. I'm gonna be famous.
Oh my god, it's gonna be the ghost of Mia. It's ridiculous. See the ghost? Aw, what a cute picture.
Well done, Capcom. Great title. Great title. Fun game, man.
And there you have it, guys. The end of the main story. Phoenix Wright. Defense lawyer undefeated thus far. That's right. All four cases. Killed. Edgeworth, we've crushed him. We've freed him. Even the perfect Von Karma, 40 years flawless record. We put him in jail. Easy peasy. GG. Rise from the Ashes. That's such a cool title for the next chapter. Oh man, I want to play it, but we can't right now. That tied everything together so perfectly. I literally cannot wait to play the next game, but we got to do the bonus case before we do. So expect that series coming up next, guys. If you've been enjoying it, I just want to say thank you so much for watching.